So far in the brewing process, we've gone through malting, kilning, mashing, and lautering. Now we have a malt-rich wort. So what we're going to do is do the boiling and hopping process. So why would we need to boil the wort at this point? The starch has been converted to sugars, and now we have all the sugar we need for the yeast. There's a few reasons to do a boil. First, by boiling, we're going to decrease the pH level, making it ready for the hops. We're also going to sterilize the wort. We want to make sure that there's no bacteria or wild yeast still active. Boiling also stops any enzymatic activity. At this point, we don't want the enzymes that we had active in the mashing process to be active. And finally, an active, vigorous boil is going to help us coagulate the proteins that was necessary in the previous steps. But we want those to start to coagulate into larger proteins to fall out of solution so that it won't cloud the beer later and we'll have an attractive, transparent beer at the end of the process. The process is as simple as it sounds. We take the wort once it has been separated from the spent grain and we start boiling it. During that process, we're going to add the hops, usually towards the end. Now, what is hops? Hops is the female flower of the hop plant. It's going to add bitter resins and antibiotic resins to our wort. The bitterness counteracts with the sweet flavor of our malt, so it's going to give us a nice tone. These bitter flavors come from alpha acids. The alpha acids are what give us the bitter component. At the boiling temperature, there are some isomerizations that we'll be looking at in the chemical concepts. We also have some beta acids that add aroma components, but often hops are selected to have lower beta than alpha amino acids. If we think about a hoppy beer, something like an Indian Pale Ale or an IPA, there are several varieties of hops added, some bitter hops and some aroma hops. Often to make sure that we get a nice aroma out of our beer, like in an IPA, we would want to add hops at the boiling phase, but also dry hopping, where we bring in the hops after the boil in the fermentation process to actually make sure we get a lot of those essential oils that may be boiled away during the boiling process. The boiling and hopping process sets up the next stage, fermentation. We have a malt-rich wort that has been sterilized so that no competitive bacteria or yeast is present. We're now ready to inoculate our wort with the variety of yeast we want in the fermentation step.